Alright guys, welcome back to the channel where today we're talking about a potential leak for WWE 2K20 as thanks to a new listing from Italian retailer Gamelife, we now have details on the three WWE Originals DLC packs that have yet to be revealed. Before we get into any of that though, if you're new to the channel, please do hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications to stay up to date with all the latest WWE 2K20 news. Now, before we get into the leak, I will say I don't know if this is legit, as there's no way to confirm it without 2K confirming it, so take it as a rumour at present. Now, the leak comes from the Italian retailer Gamelife.it, who recently updated their listing for the game to include the names of the three remaining WWE Originals DLC packs that are set to follow the Bump in the Night pack. Now, the listing for the website is in Italian, therefore I've had to translate it using Google Translate, which reveals the following information. Additional purchase is required for WWE 2K Originals No Man's Land, WWE 2K Originals Southpaw Regional Wrestling, and WWE 2K Originals The Empire of Tomorrow, each sold separately. So if this is true, then this confirms that one of the DLC packs will be featured around WWE's fictional Southpaw Regional Wrestling show, which seen various WWE superstars portraying over-the-top characters in a wrestling show that was set in the mid-1980s. So far, with everything that we know about the WWE Originals DLC and the Bump in the Night pack, then this Southpaw DLC pack does seem to fit in with the description given and the creation of new worlds to play in. As for the other two packs, the names don't really give away what they are or what they could entail, however I have been told that the pack titled No Man's Land is a loose translation, and that a better translation would be more along the lines of Wasteland, therefore if it is Wasteland, then this could be something along the lines of a Mad Max theme, or even feature the Ascension, whereas if it's indeed No Man's Land, then we could maybe see a female-centric pack featuring all female superstars. As for the Empire of Tomorrow pack, the name instantly brings to mind Asuka, although the name could also hint at something futuristic, maybe even as a replacement for the Future Stars pack to bring in new stars like Kushida. Now, those are just some examples based on the names, as like I say, we don't know what these packs will contain. The only one that we do know is the Southpaw one, as having seen the show, then we know to expect a 1980s setting with various superstars sporting comedic attires. Now, I'm once again going to stress here that we don't know if this listing is legit, but if it is, then while some people might enjoy getting Southpaw characters and having a Southpaw story add-on to the 2K showcase, personally, I'm not a massive fan of the idea, as much like the Bump in the Night pack with its zombified superstars, once you've played through the showcase add-on content and the story towers, then I don't really see any real use for these kind of characters in the game. I'd much rather have new stars like Kushida offered in these DLC packs, who I can then use outside of showcase in other modes like Exhibition or Universe. So at this point, I guess all we can do is wait and see what 2K announce and if they do indeed confirm these packs, but let me know in the comments what you think of a Southpaw Regional Wrestling pack. Is this something that you would like to see? And what do you think No Man's Land / Wasteland in the Empire of Tomorrow packs might include? Let me know your thoughts in the comments and stay tuned to the channel for full coverage on all this year's DLC as soon as it's confirmed. Until then though, have yourself an awesome day and I'll catch you later.